So this is now live, as we do have Vitae Lampada going to win the coin toss and choosing CT side for themselves against Easy Skins, Easy Life on the T side. And we already, I'm just following the auto director, but we already see Venom here being really aggressive, pushing slightly into B apps while the bomb is actually rotating over towards that underpass area. Looks like Lone Wolf is going to get boosted here onto window. Will he be able to spot Triumph, who's pushing through? Yes, he does. He gets the kill. But here comes Zephyr going a nice 2-kill from the guys pushing out connector. But here comes Lone Wolf with the retaliation kill. And Madcard, he's going to be holding here on East side by himself. He gets taken out by Lone Wolf. And that is going to leave Venom in a 1v3 situation. Poor guy. He gets a 1-kill onto Lone Wolf. So that's already a good start for him. Bomb has been planted. He did not. Oh, he does have a kid actually. So he has to. And he's picked up a Tech 9. He actually has a pretty good chance of winning this round if he can peek all the right areas. Gazer going to be holding that spot in the headshot corner while one of them. Oh, unfortunately for Gazer. Unfortunately for Venom, he gets taken out by Gazer, who was holding that ramp area by himself. So that will put Easy Skins, Easy Life up 1-0, winning the pistol round. And that'll be a nice, they'll be forcing up here onto the, CTs are kind of pretty much forced to save in this next couple rounds, unless they can win some crazy eco rounds. But here could come, all five of the CTs are pushing up through this A-Rep area. Gazer, ooh, Triumph, actually getting a nice double kill onto Parman Gazer. So that's a nice couple SMGs that picked up, but Prodigy Lone Wolf drops down from Palace and enters the A site. Terrorists do have A site control, and they will be using that to their advantage. They do get the bomb plant down. Will Zephyr be able to take out Seabear? Yes, he does, as Croc exchanges out the frag onto Zephyr. And now it is up to P-Balls. Will he be able to find Croc's out ramp? Yes, he does. Or stairs. Yes, he does. Now 1v1 situation. Lone Wolf knows where he is. Will he be able to find the peak? No, he does not get the headshot as of yet. He still has 24 bullets left. And Lone Wolf. Oh, P-Balls with the nice headshot into Lone Wolf. Will be able to take him out and secure the defuse for his team. Bomb is taking out pretty low. He does not have a kit, but that should be okay. He has just enough time to win the round. Really nice eco save there from the counter terrorists. And I mean, P-Balls coming in really clutch there for his team, able to secure that round for themselves, as they will be full buying because they did win that eco round. Now we see the reverse for the terrorist side. They are forced to save here. Of course, Easy Skin, Easy Life. Let's see what the strat is. They're all just going to be rushing towards B apps. And that is a strat that you do see a lot in Pugs. Whenever you're forced onto a save, you just rush a site. Let's see how it will work out for them. Unfortunately, Venom is going to be the only one here on B side. He does get take out one member of the terrorist team, but that's about it. Does Nate should be able to pick up second kill? Yes, he does. As Triumph will be rolling over towards Market. Gets the kill onto Gazer, and we do see a pause coming in into the middle of the match here. As looks like one of the players is having some slight technical problems, and we will be getting back into the game pretty soon. But yeah, they're just trying to solve some technical issues on one of the computers. So just give us a couple, like 30 seconds, guys, to get this resolved. And once again, shout out to V-Crank Energy Drinks for showing up, giving us the sponsorship for today's AVGL event at V-Crank Energy or vcrankenergy.com. And now we do see that the unpause is already happened, and that was really quickly for the counter-terrorists to really clean up that round for themselves. Really nice job there from Vitae Lampada to be able to get that round for themselves, which is really nice if you are on an anti-eco round like that, to be able to pick up just a couple frags, but still. Really nice job coming from a CT side. This is a mostly CT-sided map, as long as, you know, players on both sides are really skilled, and most of these players are already, you know, supreme global elite ranked, playing on ESEA and all that fun stuff. So really high caliber players here in the Massachusetts Boston area. Now for the Terrace, they are going to be trying to go for this A play here through a short. And Zephyr gets taken out by Gazer when he tried to peek through. And Magcar gets taken out by Palm. Trying to get to a couple of kills, but Gazer will take him out. And Crocs does take out Triumph. 4v2 situation, excuse me. Venom and P-Balls are the only CT left alive, as they are going to be trying to retake this site. P-Balls going up through Palace. It's going to be very sneaky here. Will he be able to find the kill onto Crocs? They know where Venom is. Venom just takes out Seabear, and they now know where P-Balls is, so they know that there's one CT and one Palace. Unfortunately, P-Balls does manage to get only one, and Venom is only down to 1-3 HP. Will he have gotten the kill? No, he does not. And Lone Wolf securing the win for his team that round. Easy Skins, Easy Lift brings it back to a 2-2 tie for his team. Really nicely done there. This counter terrorist almost had it because of that split, but because they were unable to get the necessary kills, they were only able to trade one for one instead of being more effective for a 2v1 trade or something like that. And that led to Easy Skins, Easy Left able to win that round for themselves. Three of terrorists are going to be pushing through this B apartment. P-Balls kind of missed that flashbang. Pretty sure he wanted to go towards that apps area, but unfortunately he missed the flashbang there. Be peeking towards that middle area. As we do see two members of the terrorist team boosting into the window area. And Triumph has to be very careful that he doesn't get caught out here with the op. Ooh, good kill by Crocs onto P-Balls there onto connector cat area. And that will open site up for the terrorists a little bit. But it looks like the bomb's going to be pushing straight up through connector. Will they find the kill on Makar? Makar gets one, but Gazer trades out the kill. Zephyr gets kills out Tracer, and Prodigy out trades Triumph for that fight. 3v2 situation with one member of holding CT spawn. Ooh, Crocs gets the kill onto Venom. Good lurk there coming in from Crocs. And now Zephyr, the only man left alive. He only has an op. Will he be able to find the kill? No, he doesn't. He only hits him with the scout. So unfortunately, because that CZ takes a very long time to pretty much reload in, then Paris playing it really slow, actually. And that'll be a triple for Triumph. Magcar helping his team. Oh, Magcar killing his teammate. But that is A-okay, as the CTs do manage to efficiently kick out the terrorist team. It's a good hold there by Vite Lampada in order to hold down that site by himself. Four, 3-4 is the scoreline now in this match. And I mean, luckily for the CTs, they are on a pretty good losing streak, so that they're able to afford some guns for themselves. As I mean, terrorists have been winning the last past couple of rounds, so they're doing pretty well on their economy game. Terrorists opting to take it slow once again. Gazer on that op. He wants to get some kills, but he's not finding any right now, as he is trying to peek towards that B apps area. He's not too sure where Venom is as of yet, so he has to be careful to check his corners. Oh, he does see the shoulder peek coming in from Venom. And Venom actually taking the kill onto Gazer. Really nice peek there. Good headshot coming in from Venom, able to take that kill. But here comes Triumph. He's going to be holding the corner here in connector. Will he check this corner? Yes, he does. So my card and Triumph able to hold connector by himself. But here comes Lone Wolf with the boost, able to take out Mac Hard. But Lone Wolf actually gets another kill on the Triumph. But Zephyr finally there to support his teammate. Bomb is down in connector. And Crocs, the only man left alive for the terrorist team. He has an op in hand. He gets shot from Cat and he gets surrounded. Venom managing to take him out. That was a good hold there by Vite Lampada once again. Holding their corners, holding sight. Able to take out the terrorist team with no hesitation there. So really back and forth. CT is really making a good comeback, as we can see in the past couple rounds. Easy Skins, Easy Left. I mean, they are the terrorist side. They only need a couple more rounds to really be looking good as they switch over to the second half. Terrace making a really aggressive play here onto B, just rushing straight in. Gets flash out onto Venom. Venom gets a good kill onto Lone Wolf. Gets a nice double onto C-Bear. He runs out of gun for his M4, unfortunately. And he does get taken out by Parm. Ooh, P-Balls gets unlucky. Tries to throw a grenade as he takes damage from the guy in B apartment. P-Balls gets a good kill onto Gazer, onto Arches as Crocs returns the kill with his Tech 9. Here comes Zephyr. Bomb is not yet planted. And Parm tries to take the fight. He does get taken out. That's bomb down. Crocs, the only terrorist member left alive, and gets a good kill onto Zephyr. 1v2 situation, and Traff, ooh, misses the op shot, but he does get it in the second time, and Triumph finishing the round for his team. But pretty decent round there for Easy Skins, Easy Life on their eco, but just not nearly enough. If they were able to get the bomb plant, then that would have been a lot better situation for the terrorist team. So let's see what the terrorists are able to come back down. I mean, they are on yet another save round, and they're just gonna be rushing through a main here. And Zephyr gets taken out, so a one for one exchange, not too bad coming in for the terrorists. Triumph missing the op shot, and he does finally manage to get one on the second repeat. Gets another one onto Lone Wolf on his third peak there. Oh no, C-Bar gets taken out by Nade, so does Parm. And that is Venom was a little hesitant to go defuse the bomb, but nice try there from the terrorist team. At least this time they do manage to get the bomb plant. So bonus money for them, and they should be able to buy out this round. Yeah, most of them are able to buy out. Just one person needed a drop. Double op setup here coming from the terrace. That is a really interesting play. So I'm thinking one of them is going to be peeking mid. One of them might be peeking palace. Or just might be a short and palace setup, because they are looking towards to take this A area. This A take hasn't been too successful as of yet for the past couple rounds for Easy Skins, Easy Life. But let's see with this double offset if they're able to get some more frags for themselves. CT is doing a really good job of stalling for time, utilizing all their smokes and incendiaries to really hold off the terrorists who are really aggressively looking to take this A site. Good flashbangs coming out. Say, still not yet taking the site, but here comes Lolo. He does reveal himself by throwing couple of shots out. Triumph gets a good kill onto Lolo. Zephyr also holding his own. Mad Card out in the corner gets a nice double onto Parm. That is bomb down. And Crocs, home and left alive in Palace. Ooh, he gets headshot, but Triumph taken down with a nice kill from Crocs. And it will be a 3v1 situation. Crocs not looking too healthy right now. I mean, everyone knows that he's there, checking nades one at a time. He could have tried to rotate over through A main or connector, but unfortunately he decided to just stick to palace, and that is where he will get taken out. So the CT's looking very, very strong. Their economy game is looking very strong as well. They are able to afford to buy fully this round as well as in the next round. Meanwhile on the terrorist team, they are not doing too well, but because of the amount of losses that they've incurred in a row, they should be, you know, they're at that point where they're starting to accumulate a lot more of their economy, a lot more money than they would if they just won the game. But of course, you do need rounds to win the game. So here comes Zephyr playing in the cat area. He does spot out one guy in underpass. He gets one. Would he get the second one? Yes, he does. Good peek there by Zephyr onto C-Bear. And unfortunately for the terrorists, they were just not aware of the guy that was available on cat. But here comes Gazer and Venom taking 1v1. And Venom gets the best of them, taking down 40 health, which really is still a two-shot from AK to the body. Unless you get headshotted, well then that is a one-shot kill. Unfortunately for the terrorists, it is a 5v2 scenario now, and Parm and Crocs are going to be the only players left alive. Crocs with a Tech 9 in hand. Will he be able to find any kills, really, as he holds his palace area? Good flashbang coming in from his teammates. Will he spot out the guy in CT? Yes, he does, but Madcard actually gets the frag onto him, and Triumph will finish up Parm. And that will be another round for VTail and Pada as they will take their eighth round of this first half. Really solid positioning coming in from the counter terrorists, able to peek at the right corners and really just do a good job of holding down the site as well as hitting their shots, basically. Because when it comes down to it, you know, it's all based on who can hit or who can just aim and hit their shots on the enemy team. And Vidian Lampada is doing a really good job at that. So now they're the ones with double ops up set up for the CTs. As terrorists once again forced to save up. Pistols all across the board. Only a couple of smokes and flashbangs. So not too much utility for them. Once again, they're going for A site. I mean, it's kind of harsh if you keep losing his A site. I mean, they could try a mid play. Smoking out window and connector and try to go for cat to B. That is also an option, but here comes Venom. He's going to be hiding here in the corner. He gets two headshots, but then gets taken out by Lone Wolf. So not too bad of an exchange for him. But then C-Bear takes out Zephyr, who was hiding. Here comes Triumph. Gets a good kill on C-Bear, as he will be hiding here in market with his fellow CT partner, Madcard. Flash does go out. Lone Wolf with 21 health. Oh, he does not get the spray down onto Triumph. And now Triumph, oof, watches his teammate die, but at least he's able to get the frag afterwards onto Gazer. 9-4 scoreline in favor of the CTs, Vitae Lampada. Really nice job there coming in from the CTs. And they're able to trade frags effectively, you know, two for one trades and all that good stuff. The economy game for the counter-terrorists looking very well, as they haven't, I mean, they've been winning the past like 5-6 rounds in a row, of course, so they're able to afford anything that they want, really. Easy skins, easy life as a terrorist team. They're having a much harder time winning their rounds. So, I mean, they are a losing streak, and that does mean their economy per round is actually a lot. It's more than a win round at this point, so, but they do need to get some more rounds. Here comes Lone Wolf peeking here an underpass with Crocs, or with Parm actually. A C-Ball's gonna be peeking towards that connector area. Parm, he does get a kill onto Cat, but Triumph exchanging the kill onto Parm. And here goes Triumph. He knows there's a guy close corner. He does see the flash and he's gonna be falling back with that. Pretty good call there by him as the bomb's rotating over towards that palace area. Gazer, he's not really committing anywhere actually. So after all those exchanges, it's still a 3v3 scenario. And easy skins, easy life, taking it really, really cautious approach to taking a site. I mean, Lone Wolf is up here in windows, and there is a guy sitting right outside, Triumph, holding that angle, and ooh, Triumph misses the shot! Unfortunately for him, that would have been really crucial for him, but Lone Wolf doing a good job trying to get the spray down onto Triumph. Who's he gonna go for the peek? Ooh, apparently not a good call, as the rest of his teammates get cleaned up by the other members of the CT team. So, this is gonna be the final round of the first half. 10-4 scoreline. What the terrorists really want is this next round. I mean, that'll set them up for a really good CT side in the next half. I mean, assuming that they win the pistol round as well. But here comes the terrorist team. They're gonna be pushing up straight into A main, as already Parm gets taken out by P-Balls. Good quick scope there by P-Balls in the CT spawn. Triumph once again holding jungle with his op. He gets one kill onto Cross. Gets another kill onto C-Bear. Will he get a third kill? Zephyr coming in with the support. And with that nice spray, he will get Gazer up into the scaffold. GG. First half goes to VTae Lampada. 11-4 as both sides are going to be switching. So really nice half there coming from VTae Lampada on the counter-terror side, which is to be expected, honestly. On a map like Mirage. So let's see if Easy Skins get an easy life. Can reverse sweep it coming from a deficit of 7 rounds on the CT side. VTae Lampada going for a main push here. taking it pretty slowly. I guess they're just waiting the nades out, but most of them do have armor on, so this is an interesting play. Here go. They spot one guy at CT. Will they find out there's a guy in jungle? Crox gets a good kill on the Triumph. Perm and Crox gets another kill as Gaze are trying to get a frag for himself. 4v2 situation. Venom and Magcart having a very difficult situation finding cards to land, and Crox finishing them both off, actually getting a nice 4k for himself in this pistol round. So good job to Crox, able to land his shot onto the terrorist team. That will bring the score to 11-5 in favor of Retail and Pada, and they will be, I mean, they have the option to force up here. Yeah, easy skins, easy life, forcing out here. Smart call. So able to come back from that. Alright, VTail and Pada looks like they're going for a B split push. They do have, CTs do have one person in window, so they are able to spot the guys who are trying to go to cap. Bomb is rotating over towards that B apps area. We have two CT members holding B apps. Lone Wolf with a close quarter arrow, and Parm is going to be right underneath him. But here comes Venom. He does check his corner. That's a good entry kill onto that B site. And Seabear actually gets a nice double kill onto the guys who are rotating over Kappa. Zephyr helps out his teammate by taking the kill. Bomb is planted. He will pick up an SMG for himself. So really good play there. 3v3 scenario for easy skins, easy life. Will they be able to find the frag? Zephyr is close. Smoke here. Venom with 11 health gun behind here in apartments. Two people mark it. Here comes Parm pushing out, and Crox gets taken out by Magcart, and Gazer tits out Zephyr. Last guy is Venom, who is at 11 health in apartments, and they will be able to find the kill. Congratulations to Gazer, able to find that last headshot onto easy skin, easy life. But the bomb is taking out really little. Does he have time? Is he able to get this? Oh no! Unfortunately for easy skin, easy life, just not enough time to win the round. That's really unfortunate when you get all the frags, but you were just half a second too late to securing that bomb defuse. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why you buy a defuse kit. So VTail and Pada gets a good win from the cells because of that bomb plant. And they are going to be forcing up. Not too many utility nades on their side. Couple AKs, couple Galils, and MP7. As Parm's going to be just going for a pretty standard setup. Two members of the CT side actually being really aggressive on that B site, pushing out apartments into T spot. As Gaze are trying to take the kill, and Triumph will be able to secure it by rushing towards that stairs area. Here comes Lua from A-May. Ooh, P-Balls gets caught out with his gun not drawn. And he will get another kill onto Zephyr, who tried to plant the bomb. That is going to be bombed down as Triumph will be able to take care of Seabear. Venom gets taken out by Lone Wolf. And Triumph, with no health left, will get taken out by Crox. Once again, another good hold by this counter-terrorist team, as they will be picking up another frag for themselves. Another round for themselves, excuse me. 12-6. So still got plenty of time to play with. VTail and Pada have to be careful in their strategic decisions as to what they want to push and not push. I mean, it's really difficult as a terrorist on this map because there's just so many open angles that you have to peek. And the CTs have really close corners that they're able to hold. But it looks like the terrorists are going to be rushing towards this BS area. Seabear already gets a nice kill for himself in the beginning, but here comes the terrorists. They're going to be overrunning the site pretty soon. Seabear gets another kill for himself. Croc holding the site down with him, and Lone Wolf, ooh, he gets danked pretty well by a guy over at Van, but not a single member of the CT side die. So good hold there by Easy Skins Easy Life, able to take another round for themselves against a, you know, a terrorist team who just saved. It looks like the T's, I mean, they don't have the economy, really. Could have forced, but they are in no rush to do so because they do have 5 rounds ahead of the enemy team. So once again, they're going for a quasi-buy here with just 5 pistols across the board against a fully stacked up counter-terrorist team. 3 members of the CT of the terrorist team pushing through this area. Will they find Gazer, who's lurking here in connector. Oh, P-balls. Yes, he does. But he gets traded out by Cross. Proc's actually getting a nice double, triple kill, actually. Really good peek there. And spray control coming from Parm, finding himself a kill over at the Palace area. Madcar, the only man left alive. Is he able to clutch it for his team? He does have the bomb. But it is against four members of the counter-terrorist team. So chances are not looking too well for him. They still have full nades utility in their disposal. So the best he can go for are a bunch of 1v1 situations and try to get a bomb plant. Here he is. He decided to go for a main push. Does have the bomb in hand. Will he be able to spy out Parm in the CT spawn area? He's slowly walking, so he does not reveal himself as of yet to where his location is. But once he starts playing the bomb, Parm should know where to look. Yep, here comes the plant, and Parm's going to be peeking out, and gone. So good try by Madcard. I mean, it was a really tough round for him, able to 4v1 like that. But, I mean, if he wanted to, he could have faked the defuse and then gone for a kill. But, I mean, you never know where they're going to peek from. You don't know if they're CT or jungle or stairs, so... It was a nice try, but at least now the terrorist team are able to full buy. I mean, the CT economy, they're able, even if they lose this round, they are able to full buy again next round, except for Gazer and Seabear, but that's A-okay. So the rest of the team can drop for them. So once again, a 2-1-2 setup. Two members of the counter-terrorist team will be holding this A-site, while the five members of the terrorist team going to be... Yep, here they are setting up for all of the smokes necessary for that A push. And here comes the smokes. Follow up the smokes with some flashbangs. Gazer, really nice peek there onto Madcard. Gets a kill on Madcard and Palace. But here comes Parm peeking in the corner against Venom. Gets a good kill for himself. Terrorists struggling to find their shots here. Unable to find the peek, find the angles. P-Ball taking the fight onto the CT spawn area. But he's not able to take anyone down. Lone Wolf gets a good kill on the P-Ball, but does not see the guy in the smoke. Zephyr gets a one kill for himself. Triumph, nice quick kill onto Crocs at CT spawn. And then, oh, it's a 1v3. I mean, with the op, he can try to clutch it. He does see Gazer, but he does not know where Parm is. He might be able to spot out Seabear, who's lurking at stairs, but here comes Parm. Good smoke there onto the CT spawn. Unfortunately, there's no one at CT at this moment. Here comes Triumph playing the ball. He could fake the plant, but unfortunately, he tries to go for it, and Parm will get the kill. So CT's closing the gap really, really soon now. Round difference is only 3 rounds now. That's easy skin, easy life. Doing work by clawing their way back into this game. Vini Lampada hasn't won. I mean, they've only round 2 rounds so far once they switch sides, as compared to Easy Skin's Easy Life, who have won 4. However, we do see that a pause has come through. Looks like one of the players once again is having trouble with their computers. So we'll be getting back into action just 1 second. As soon as he fixes his stuff. What's up, Major Fatal? Mr. J Fatal, how you doing today, sir? So more CSGO action will come up soon, as soon as the pause is released. Yeah, one of the players is just having some technical problems here. So this is the Boston LAN. Isn't there a Texas LAN going on as well? There probably is. There's actually a lot of tournaments going on today, so... League of Legends Worlds was held today, obviously. There's Fragadelphia in Philly that has a CSGO tournament, and there's also one in Texas as well. And there is also a big tournament going on Twitch right now. I believe it's... Well, at least when I was watching it, it was a Penta versus Envious. So that is also going on as well. So there's lots of tournaments going on this weekend. And yeah, there's definitely a lot of CSGO action to watch. So, you guys get to take your pick. And that is going to be the unpause here coming in from the admin. So, we're going to get back into the Counter-Strike action. Zephyr gets good kill onto Gazer over here in Connector. That's a good opening pick for the terrorist team here. Now here comes Lone Wolf taking an aggressive approach here onto this cat area. And then he falls back towards ladder room. Really smart play. Venom gonna be holding the corner. Ooh, but Lone Wolf takes the fight and wins it once again. As Triumph pushes out towards BFs, gets a good kill onto Lone Wolf, who rotated over from that cat area. Now here comes B site is clear, but Triumph, ooh, gets taken out by Crocs, who was holding market for his team. Bomb has not yet rotated over. Zephyr knows that there is a guy over at market, so he's going to have to be careful watching his guy plant the bomb. 29 seconds left, so they still have plenty of time to work with. Now it looks like Magcart is going for that bomb plant. Is he going to? He spots out Crocs, but he's unable to get the frag. Zephyr gets taken down, and then easy skins, easy life. 3v1 since you know. Magcart gets taken out. Very nice play there by easy skins, easy life. And that brings him to a 12-10 scoreline. Easy skins, easy life on that CT side, making a huge comeback so far. And if this trend continues to go, if the momentum holds for them, then this counter-terrorist have a really good chance of coming back in this game. Alright, so looks like Zephyr is having some computer issues, so he's been just been having a little bit of problem with his computer and stuff, but it's okay. We're still gonna be going for this game. Looks like Vidi and Lampada once again going for a B push. P-Ball's getting ready his flashbang for his team. Two members of the CT's holding apartment, so they should be ready to intercept any of the terrorists that do come through. Triumph, he does CC balls. Ooh, one health left from Triumph, but here comes the push up. Lone Wolf gets a good kill onto Zephyr, who tried to go in. That will stall the terrorist push out very long. P-Balls, ooh, good kills by Magcart and P-Balls to Lone Wolf and C-Bear. As that looked pretty scary in the beginning for the terrorist team. Triumph holding ledge by himself with one health. And here's three members of the CT team left alive. Are they going to be going for it though? They should be able to. Time is ticking down as it is only a 30 second bomb timer. And he does. Oh, Gazer with the one health. He's unfortunately unable to get the kill with his off. Magcart holding a good angle on Van to see the bomb. 2v1 and Parm. I mean, he's pretty much stuck here. Parm does get the kill on the mad card. But that's going to be the terrorist team who wins that round. So unfortunately for Easy Skins Easy Life, they just weren't able to really capitalize on the defuse. And Vita Lampada doing a good job of holding the site by themselves. 13-10 is the score, as we all can see. The economy for the terrorists, I mean, if they lose this round, then they're going to be forced onto a save. But that can be said once again for the for the CTs as well. So the future of this game kind of hangs in the balance of this round, as the economy for both teams are pretty much shattered at this point. Zephyr taking a quick peek in connector, but Gazer takes him down. Good support there by Crocs, able to take out Triumph. Fortunately for the terrorists, they were just unable to get the kills that they need. Bomb is over at the apps area though. And Lone Wolf once again playing super close. Is C-Ball going to check the corner? No, he does not. Lone Wolf, ooh, running out of ammo, but does have C-Bear to back him up. Good teamwork there. Able to protect Lone Wolf from dying at this corner. And now, oh, what a good spray coming in from Lone Wolf onto Venom. That's really good. That's just really good game sense there. Able to spot out the guy in kitchen, know that he backed off, and get the spray down. Yeah, that was just a really good game sense there. Able to finish that round for themselves. And CTs, once a round, only a 2-round deficit for Easy Skins, Easy Life. They have a good chance of bringing this back, as Vida and Lampada forced onto a save. And yes, Major Fatal, some of these team names are quite hilarious. Vidi Lampada 5 members of the terrorist team here in Palace. I mean, they only have pistols, no armor, 1 flashbang. They're going to go for it. YOLO swag. And here comes the push. Parm is going to be in the CT spot and the paw. Okay. We do have another pause coming in the middle of the round. So yeah, as we can see, Mad Card is, well, let's see. Parm is holding here in the CT spawn area. He's going to be peeking out and seeing 4 members of the terrorist team rushing towards him, and he's going to have an awkward time. We do have Geza up in stairs to support him, as well as Crox, who's going to be killing Z-Balls pretty soon. You can see the crosshairs next to him. But, I mean, the crosshairs... Oh! It is live once again. And here comes a good kill. Good kills by Parm. Wow, just good frags overall. That was... a slaughter, as we should have expected. Very nice there. Very nicely done by these counter-terrorists, able to hold their sights. So Vita Lampada, now they're starting to feel the pressure. Easy skins, easy life has caught up to 12 rounds now. So they are forcing up 2 scouts and 3 AKs coming in from the terrorist team. Not too sure about this. Maybe, I mean, I personally don't like the scout, so anytime a team buys a scout, I'm really hesitant. But let's see if they can use this effectively. Good smokes onto Stair and CT. Not really able to convert connector though, but they do get good exchange there. Bomb will get planted down, and this is going to be the pressure onto the counter-terrorist team, who are going to be trying to go for the retake. Gazer spots a guy up in Palace. So he's going to be... Oh, good kill. Onto good patience, really, by Gazer to get the kill onto Venom. Ooh, misses the shot there in connector, though. Oh, there he does. He gets the kill onto Triumph, and that will be the only one guy left. Mad Card holding headshot box by himself. Really good clutch there, but Seabear managing to take out... Oh, but there's no time! Oh, there's just not enough time. Poor Seabear tried his best to clutch it for his team, but he just came too late. Not a huge fan of CSGO, but going to Advanced Warfare Land next week, AVGO Society, see how the CSGO scene is here. Oh, the CSGO scene is pumping, dude. Like, whenever registration starts up, these slots, unfortunately, because it's such a small venue, it fills up really quickly. So, I mean, the interest is there. There's just not enough of a capacity to fill that interest. So, it's always popular. It's always pumping over here, man. Good to see that you're coming out for Advanced Warfare Land next week. So, that's pretty cool. Going back into the game, I mean, terrorists once again, because they were able to win that round. Force buying up. Counter-terrorists, full buying up. And here comes the A push once again. They did well to execute. Oh, really good flash there coming in from the counter-terrorist, but unfortunately they are all smoked out. P-Boss does. Ooh, CT is not yet covered. Parm had the opportunity to stop the bomb plant if he so choose. Venom holding headshot box. Only gets dinked a couple of damage. But that's about it. Good nade gonna hit Venom to drop him. Actually only down to 66 health, so not too much damage done to him. And once again, another pause coming in the middle of the round, so slightly awkward. Technical issues all around. But yeah, it is another pause. So the CTs are on the full retake. We do see like Prodigy, Lone Wolf here. Gazer holding headshot box, and then we have Parm who's just rushing out towards Tetris area and all that fun stuff. So once this game resumes in the next few seconds, we're gonna see lots of action picking up. Let's see what's going on right now. Once again, technical problems with one of the computers for, I believe it is Easy Skin Easy Life. So Victor is going to be, looks like they're just trading out some equipment. It's just going to be another minute or so before we resume this CSGO action. But in the meantime, I just want to take this pause time to give a big shout out to V-Crank Energy Drinks. They had a couple of their representatives out here today, gave out some really cool product, their energy drink, V-Crank Energy. It tastes really good, honestly, in comparison to like the other energy drinks that I've had over my past lifetime. Fueling nerds as we compete in these LAN events. So if you guys have time, give them a quick follow on their Twitter. They have Facebook and whatnot. That's V-Crank Energy Drink. You can visit their website. They have a Twitter. I know I followed them today. So big shout out to them for sponsoring AVGL and able to have events like this to in the Boston area, at least. I know that the esports scene in the East Coast not as big as it is out in California, but we are doing our best to make all that come true. So here comes the repause as Parm. We are going to be spectating Parm here. He does for an awkward taking off his barrel, but he does get a nice double kill onto the guy at headshot box. And Tetris guy. Oh, another quick pause here. Slightly awkward, but C-Bear, he knows where P-Balls is. And they should be killing each other soon. Parm is going for the defuse. So it is up to the three remaining counter-terrorists to really protect the guy. I mean, he has a kit, so all they had to do is defend him for 5 more seconds before the round is over. But yeah, the CSGO scene in Cali, obviously, Cali is like the big epicenter for esports. In the East, it's a pretty scattered. The interest is here, but it's pretty scattered among the different states here in the Northeast. So having good centralized local LAN areas like AVGL really helps. Obviously there's Fragadelphia going on right now this instant in Philly, and that's another like small CSGO event that's happening on the East Coast as well. And once again, I want to thank you guys for tuning in to watch like small events like this that's going on. Really helps promote esports as a whole. And once companies see the interest, more sponsorships, more money is gonna get pulled into scenarios such as this. Esports Hero TV, yes, East Coast esports scene is on the rise. That is true, sir. I agree with you. It is definitely on the rise, and I mean it's gonna turn into that East versus West thing that people talk about. With how often huge the Fragadelphia lands are, I'd say East Coast and West Coast are pretty even. But obviously there's not huge stuff like ESL is not held, like ESL events are not held here yet. We do have IEM events for like Dota and League that's held, but in terms of CSGO events, not really too many. CSGO is still concentrated in the EU area. But yeah, overall esports is rising as a whole, and I really like to see that. So thank you guys for tuning in. Love you people. Keep up your interest and support esports as a whole, because esports is amazing and fun. Hopefully this pause, oh there we go, the pause gets unpause as C-Bear and Zephyr will get taken down. All the terrorists are down. Parm gets the defuse. Easy skin, easy life. Takes another round for themselves. 14-13 scoreline. And terrorists once again broke. They are forced to save this round, which should bring it to a 14-14 scoreline. And that is going to force the terrorists to really come up with something innovative to take the rounds back for themselves. Looks like Vidi Lampada, they're actually going, ooh, this is an interesting play. So they're going mass underpass into probably connector A area. Crox is holding this area here. Ooh, Gazer, nice quick peek onto Madcar. Gets a quick kill for himself. Crox, he gets spotted out in mid. Oh, but that grenade's gonna do quite some damage to the terrorists who try to boost up into window. Triumph unable to get the window boost that he really needed. But here they come onto this A site. Parm gets a good kill, trading out the kill from P-Balls as Venom sneaks up onto Crocs, gets him down from window room. Lone Wolf, Seabear, Parm, the only three CT members left. But Venom, ooh, Zephyr gets taken out really low by Seabear. That is going to be bombs. A good peek there by Seabear. And now Venom will get taken out in CT spawn by Lone Wolf. Very nice rotation there from Easy Skin, Easy Life. To be expected. And now Vilampada, 14-14 scroll, and they are forced to do something here if they want the win. Lone Wolf will not help frag me. Yep, round is now live once again. And CTs. Oh, another pause. A little awkward stuff. But the terrorists going for a B execute? Yep, B execute through B apps. Mad Card going for the support role for his team. And what is going on? So looks like we're just having a lot of things going on right now. But yeah, lots of pauses plagued in this game. Sorry for that, everyone. Must be pretty upsetting to just sit and watch people. Look at Zephyr down in the corner. His feet are just moonwalking there in position. That's ever since they update the new models, it's pretty funny to watch the character models just like do crazy random stuff. It's pretty funny. But yeah, once again, another pause coming in as now looks like a member of the terrorist team have a problem with their computer. What's this pause stuff you've never seen happen? I know, Mr. Fatal. There's just been a lot of pause with some equipment stuff from both teams. Both teams are eligible for 10 minutes of pause for both teams, so they can use that up however they want because of the technical issues with their computers, their mouse, their all their other stuff. But it is fine. We want everyone to have a fair chance at winning this tournament. I mean, it is 14-14, so I mean, this is the round that will determine who will win this match, unless some crazy comeback stuff from either Vilampada or Easy Skin, Easy Life happens in the next few seconds. So once again, I want to give a quick shout out to V-Crank Energy. I mean, I've had a can of it right here. It's delicious. It's better than most of the energy drinks that I've had. And I get thirsty pretty quickly. So V-Crank Energy Drink. Shout out to them. I'm once again Defu from casterscaravan.com, and we provide shoutcasting services to small or big CSGO, League of Legends, Dota, Hearthstone, Smash, all the esports titles that you can think of. We have shoutcasters who are willing to go out to these events, such as myself, to provide shoutcasting for them. And of course, thank you viewers for tuning in to watch this match between local Massachusetts area players. Right now is currently Vilampada versus Easy Skins Easy Life in the losers bracket round one, and we're hoping to solve their technical issues soon. Looks like they're still trying to fix that stuff before they are able to really do anything about that. Hey, I see Luop in the chat. Shout out to Luop. Paul Luop actually came in a couple weeks ago, shoutcasted with me. He's a really cool guy. If you guys want to check him out, he has his Twitter. It's at It's Luwap. His Twitch is twitch.tv/Luwap with two U's. He's a really cool guy. You guys can check him out. So shout out to Paul. I love you, man. Wish you could come out to more of these. And we are going to see the resume here to get back into the Asha Vida Lampada versus Easy Skin, Easy Life. All the terrorists here bunched up in the B apartments area. Slow execute here coming in from the team. Mad Car calling in for another pause. Another game crash. Oh no. Sorry about the delay, everyone. This is not the ideal situation for any of the players or spectators, of course. Call of Duty Shoutcasting, you guys cover Mr. J Fiddle. Yes, we do. Just contact us through our website, casterscaravan.com, and we will open up a private conversation for any Call of Duty events. Any esports events, we will do, sir. So don't worry about that. But here comes... Ooh, we do see Prodigy Lone Wolf being really aggressive there with that smoke. I'm not sure if they were able to hear him jump into apartments area. Smoke is going to dissipate, and here comes C-Ball's able to exchange out the kill there onto Lone Wolf. And P-Ball's once again gets a good kill on the Crocs. Triumph gets a nice headshot onto C-Bear, opening that site up for his teammate as Gazer and Parm, the only two members left alive. Gazer holding market here. Two of the terrorist members are going to be at the fan area with Mad Card holding out ledge. Here comes Gazer. Is he going to check it out? Yes, he does. He gets one kill onto Mad Card. Switches out for AK. Really smart move as P-Balls takes out his partner in crime, Parm. Just like that. Whoo! VD Lampada. Good hold onto that bomb site. 15-14. This is the final round of this. The loser of this, unfortunately, will get knocked out of the tournament. So, Easy Skins, Easy Life. I mean, unfortunately for them, their economy was not looking too well before the string of pauses. But now they are forced to buy up as it is the last round before overtime. So here comes the bomb. Looks like terrorists are going for an A play. It is going to be Venom holding the corner here onto Palace while the rest of the terrorist team lurking down into A main. But here comes Crocs. He's really loud. But he is sneaking up on the terrorist team. This could be a very devastating play for the terrorists if they don't find out where he is. Here comes the A execute. The members are pushing onto site. Good flashbang onto the terrorists. Are they gonna see Gazer? Gazer up holding onto the stairs. And Crocs getting only one kill, unfortunately, from the Lurk. But here goes Seabird. He does stop the bomb carrier. And Venom pushing through the smoke. Ooh, kicks out Venom. And that is gonna be 2v4 right now. Unfortunately, we just might be able to see our first overtime here at the AVGL. Gazer kicks out Venom. And Speedballs, ooh, gets taken out by Seabird. Easy skin, easy life. Wow. And that is gonna be our first overtime. So in all 7 CSGO LAN events, this will actually be the first overtime that I get to watch. And everyone, we are in it for a real treat because this is the first overtime ever, and it will be between VD Lampada and Easy Skins Easy Life. Overtime is live. Both teams buying out. Gazer with the op versus Triumph on the terror side with the op. We'll see what type of strats they guys have to play. Ooh, Zephyr unable to get the kill. Or he does get the kill on the Croc, but he is down to 9 health. As Lone Wolf holding that apartment site by himself. So already the CT team down one player. Let's see how the terrorist team can really come back from that. Bomb is roading over towards that BF's area. Seabear pushing up slightly. He has to be pretty careful because the bomb is over towards that B apartments area. Here comes Triumph peeking off in mid. Ooh, he spots the guy in connector. Unable to kill him though, only legs him with that shot. And here comes the terrorist. Good fire onto burning out Seabear. Seabear has to fall back. He's taken down really low. He actually dies to the fire. Oh no, Seabear. That was a really smart incendiary, to be honest, by VD Lampada. And that will be the terrorist pushing onto site. Triumph gets a good kill onto Gazer, who was trying to secure himself into a position. But Parm, the only CTA member left alive, he will be able to save the op for himself and his team. But in terms of the retake, he's not going to go for it. So that is the first overtime round going towards the terrorist team. Vidi Lampada, all five members are left alive. And Easy Skins, Easy Life, they have to come up with a strat to come back from that one. So really nice job there by the terrorist team, able to secure that first round for them. Whew! Dang, this is really close. Unfortunately, because the CTs did fall by that last round, some of the CTs are going to be forced into really bad gun situations. I mean, Gazer, actually, they're able to fall by there. Never mind, don't listen to me. I'm pretty bad at this. But that B execute there from the terrorist team was really, really well executed. Able to get some key frags and that fire, man. C-Bear was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Good kill by Gazer in that mid area to spot out the guy who was peeking underpass. Zephyr does get taken out. Bomb is towards that lower underwater area. Ooh, P-Ball is unable to hit the shot. And Gazer will be able to take out P-Balls because of that misplay. Triumph, good boost there. Able to take out Gazer, who's opping there from the mid window area. Bomb is over here onto this B-Apps area. Once again, we do see Lone Wolf holding close corner area. Mad Card. Ooh, oh no, Triumph taking an unnecessary kill onto Venom. And that, I mean, in this situation, that is a really awkward thing to do. Triumph will just get taken out by a nade from Crocs. Back in fourth game, Easy Skins, Easy Life, winning the second round for them team. And, I mean, jeez, back in fourth indeed. 16-16 scoreline, overtime number one. And it will be, I mean, there's just no advantage to this. Full buys coming in from both teams. And this time, Vidi Lampada opting for a push. Lone Wolf here holding the B apps by himself, but that doesn't really matter if most of the terrorists are into that A area. Oh, here comes Gazer, and here's the execute. Good fire there onto A main. Unfortunately, doesn't slow them down too much. Gazer trying to find an angle onto the terrorist team, but he's not able to find it just yet. Gazer gets a good kill onto P-Balls, who tries to plant the bomb. That is the B-Balls that Gazer holding stairs here. Zephyr gets a kill onto Lone Wolf. Quick scope there by Gazer, able to take the win for that exchange. Now Triumph with the off. Ooh, misses the shot onto Gazer. It is a 1v3 scenario for Triumph. Unfortunately for him, he has so many spots to check, and C-Bear gets the better of him from that area. And able to win that round for him. Easy Skin, Easy Life taking overtime one with a one round advantage, 17-60. Oh my god, let's see these two teams back and forth. So they are having really close game here from both teams. $10,000 buy from everyone. So now we do see the teams being swapped up over. Easy Skin, Easy Life is gonna be on the terrorist side. At least see how they can execute on their terrorist side. Honestly, when they're on the CT side, I expected them to win a couple more rounds than that. Because Mirage is more of a CT sided map. But that is okay. Ooh, Triumph. Good peek there onto Gazer in the mid, able to win that round for him and his team. So that will bring into a 4v5 as Terra is forced to slow down their play once again. The slow peaks not working out too well on for the terrorist team here. C-Bear shooting a couple warning shots there in mid. Zephyr, unfortunately, not able to land that Molly. Good flash by Crocs. Will he be able to fight Triumph, who's so close to his corner? He's looking towards Cat, which is not a bad place to look at, honestly, but Triumph holding the close corner for himself. And he does get traded out. good boost, but unable to make effect of anything from there. And Zephyr gets a good kill onto the guy who's trying to peek through connector. Now C-Bear, only terrorist member left alive. 20 seconds on the clock. 10 health. There's not really not much he can do. He's surrounded by all of the enemy players of the counter-terrorist team. And time's taken. He's just gonna go for it. YOLO. He will get taken out by P-Balls. Very nice hold there by the counter-terrorist team. Triumph did a really good job holding Window by himself with the help of his teammate Zephyr there. As, once again, terrorists are gonna be full buying here. Second to last round of this overtime match. Scoreline 17-17. No one really in favor of winning just of yet. It is a pretty back and forth fight between these two teams, battling for that spot to not get eliminated from today's tournament. As this is the losers round one match between these two. We see the terrorist going here for execute. C-Bear holding onto that smoke for dear life, waiting for the call out from his team to when he wants to peek out. Gazer is probably going to be peeking the guy over at stairs, who is Mad Card. And here comes the execute. Smokes and flashes do go out. Mad Card gets a good kill onto Crocs, but he might get taken out by the terrorist who jumped over towards that stair area. Gazer, will he find the shot? Yes, he does, onto Mad Card. 4v4 right now, as bomb is not yet. There it is. There's the bomb plant. Zephyr, will he check his corner? No, he doesn't. Lone Wolf gets a good frag onto Zephyr there. And C-Bear gets a good kill to B-Balls sitting there on site. C-Bear gets a good kill on the telephone booth. Venom, the only CT member left alive. He does check stairs. And unable to get the frag, actually. As Lone Wolf takes him out with his AK-47. Easy skin, easy life. Final round of this first overtime. And easy skin, easy life ahead. 18-17. Vitae Lampada has to win this if they don't want to get eliminated. And here comes Vitae Lampada, CT side. Easy skin, easy life. Who will take this overtime match? I'm not sure if you guys can hear, but there are the cheers out there. Whew, 17-18. This is close. The tension is building. Good flashbang, but Venom unable to see anyone. That was a flashbang from his teammate, actually. So that kind of spooked him out. Here it comes. Slow game here coming in from both teams. Lone Wolf peeing here onto that middle area. He does not know about the Gone Cat. Zephyr taking a pretty passive approach. He sneaks up on the guy. Oh, Gazer actually gets a good kill onto Mad Card. And that will be Lone Wolf taking the kill on the Triumph in window area. Will they know that there's a guy in CT? Oh, he does not, as the CT will take him out. So easy skin, easy life. Bomb is currently down, as P-Balls is going to be holding the CT site area. P-Balls, good flash. Bomb is still dropped. There is one member of the terrorist team on Palace. Ooh, misses the shot. C-Bear actually gets a good kill onto Zephyr, who is over at jungle. So they know that there's a guy in CT. 2v2 scenario. P-Balls, unfortunately. Oh, he does get the shot actually onto C-Bear. So C-Bear does get taken out. 2v1 scenario, as only there's one member left alive, and that's Crocs. Crocs is going to be going for the plant. And he does spot the guy out in connector. He does get one. 10 seconds. 8, 7, 6. He's going for the fake defuse. The fake plant. Oh, good. Crocs secures the kill for his team. Easy skin, easy life. Finally wins the overtime. Congratulations to them. They're going to be advancing to the loser's final. Loser's bracket, round 2. Whew, that was a really fun and close game, guys. That overtime match and easy skin, easy life. Crocs able to clutch it for his team. I mean, that was a really good game. Really close overall, and that is one to be remembered for weeks to come. Whew! So that'll do it for right now. The next match will start in 10 minutes. I'm Defu for Cassius Caravan. This is AVGL's CSGO LAN number 7. Shout out to VCrank Energy for sponsoring today's event, sponsoring AVGL, supporting esports, CSGO esports events here on the East Coast in Boston, Massachusetts. We'll be back in 10 minutes as we will be seeing Easy Skin, Easy Life taking on As Is Tradition in the next semifinals match. So give us 10 minutes, guys. We're going to go to a quick 10-minute break, and we'll be back with more CSGO action after that. And that was a crazy-ass game.